It's match day at the Liberty Stadium this Friday when the Ospreys welcome Connacht in the Guinness PRO12. Join us at Llandarcy Academy of Sport now as we look ahead to the match in the company of Steve Tandy, Sam Parry and Rynier Bernardo. Sam, you had to be patient those last few weeks. Scott's been in good form in the number two jersey and you had to wait for your chance to start, but it's coming this weekend. You must be pretty excited.
Yeah, no, definitely. Scott's been playing very well beginning of the season, so it's good to get a chance now this week and just looking forward to the next few weeks, hopefully get some game time in the shirt now.
Have Gibbo and Tandy given you any messages, told you what they want to see from you now on Friday night?
Not really, just to relax and just enjoy it and just do what you're good at really, so just hopefully just try and take the pressure off and just enjoy it.
It's been a bit strange, obviously you've been part of a pack that's been pretty consistent in selection over the last few weeks. Now a lot of new boys, youngsters and other boys coming into the squad, so it's going to be a bit of a strange feel. How is everyone blending in together and training?
Yeah, there's a lot of new faces and stuff, but we've got a good few sessions this week and everyone seems to know their roles, so everyone's just looking forward to getting out there now and just showing what they can do.
And this month, as always, the Ospreys, when international players are away, it's a big opportunity for people to show what they can do and stake a claim for a place. So you, amongst others, will be looking to really send a message to the coaches, I'd have thought.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, this is a window a lot of boys target when the internationals go away, so it's just about just getting out there, enjoying it and trying to put on the best performances you can.
And we're playing Connacht Friday night. They've had a great start to the season themselves, so it's going to be tougher than ever against them, I'd have thought.
Yeah, they've been really good this season, so it's going to be a big game and a tough ask, but boys, like I said, looking forward to it and just want to get going now.
As you may have read already at ospreysrugby.com, Friday night's game has been dedicated to the Royal British Legion's poppy appeal. Representatives from the British Legion will be attending on Friday night and they'll be bringing their band down to perform ahead of kick-off, so make sure you take your seat nice and early to enjoy the entertainment. They'll also be collecting for the poppy appeal around the ground, so please dig deep and help the Legion while supporting your region. If you're attending the game with your club as part of our ticketing initiative, then don't forget that you can get 10% off all Ospreys stock when you show your ticket in the club shop on match day. So make sure you come along, have a look around and pick up your merchandise ahead of the game. This week, the Ozone takes on a brand new look as we introduce the Hallowzone for one night only. Come and join us for some Halloween-themed games and make sure you wear your best costume as we'll have an award for the best-dressed Halloween outfit on the night. Barcy from Nando's will once again be in attendance and he'll be looking to take on Ozzy in a head-to-head Halloween special in the Hallowzone. We'll also have competitions for kids, including a pumpkin hunt with several pumpkins hidden inside the Hallowzone. So join us nice and early for the fun. The Hallowzone is open from 6:05 p.m. Stephen, it's the start of a very busy period as the season moves on to a new chapter. What's the mood in the camp as we're preparing for Connacht on Friday?
Yeah, the boys are excited, patching one or two things up, but no, the boys are excited. It's a big game for us, and obviously unbeaten in the league is something that we want to keep that momentum going, and down the Liberty it'll be a good night on Friday.
It's always a time of the year when we start to see new faces coming in and there's a lot of weight on young shoulders this time of the year. Probably more so than ever this season with a couple of injuries building up and boys coming in who supporters might not be too familiar with.
Yeah, there'll be a couple of boys we're not familiar with, but it's something that it's an experience for them, and obviously with the international call-ups and with a bit of a injuries taking a toll a little bit, but it's something that we're pretty excited about. You can see training today, the boys know their role and the only way to gain experience is by playing, so it's something that we've prepared for. We said all along that we know there'll be some ebbs and flows throughout the season and it'll be no different come Friday.
When you come in on Monday morning off the back of a disappointing result, disappointing performance in Northampton, is it a good thing or a bad thing that you've got a different group to be working with this week?
I suppose you can look at it two ways, but it's something that we haven't sort of looked back a little too much because a lot of those boys who played in our year, so it's something we're just trying to get excited and get the boys up to speed because this sport moves on quite quickly, so we need to get a performance now coming to Connacht.
and it's a difficult game against Connacht. They've impressed this season. What are you expecting from them?
Well, they're a good team, and like at the end of the day, their league position is a real positive one. They're a real good start, and they've got a good squad. They don't get hit as much as most teams through this period, so this is a strong sort of part of the season for them. They're confident, and it's something we know we're going to have to be at the sort of capacity to perform on Friday.
I'm just looking a little bit further ahead. Beyond this weekend, we've got back-to-back matches in the LV Cup at Meath and at Bridgend. Another exciting little period for these young boys.
Yeah, it's always great for us. It's been a great tournament, and like you see the boys we brought through that, in like sort of King, Tips, Eli, Becky, Webby, they've all come and produced performances in that. So it's the next generation getting ready for the Guinness and hopefully getting them ready for Champions Cup. But yeah, we played an A game a couple of weeks ago where some of these boys have had good preparation. They've been in this week, so it is a positive experience. It's something we always look forward to on the calendar and really enjoy sort of coaching, and we'd be preparing just the same as any other week.
Rynier, disappointment at Northampton last weekend. What's the thoughts after that game?
Oh, well, you know, I think we went up there with a strong feeling. I haven't lost the game in the league, and then starting the Champions League, the European League off well, you know, against Treviso, and then we probably took our foot off the gas a bit in Northampton. I think one or two things we didn't get right, but luckily we've got them again at home.
And we're straight back into it this weekend with Connacht, minus international players and one or two injuries mounting. So there's a lot of weight on the shoulders of people like yourself to lead some of the youngsters coming into the team.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of new faces around, which is nice. You know, it brings a nice little energy to training and things. And with some of the guys being away with international duties and things, it gives a lot of guys some chances. But no pressure. I mean, the coaches have said to us this week, go, you know, express yourself, keep doing what we're doing. We're undefeated in the Robbo, so let's just keep going.
It's probably a bit of a strange experience for you coming from South Africa, where the season is more structured in blocks, to be involved now when internationals are going away and we've got two competitions continuing. It's probably a strange one.
Yeah, it is a bit different. Things seem to overlap frequently now with some of the international players being away with the autumn tests and things, and then next year at the start of the year with the Six Nations, whereas in South Africa, you know, you have a test break during Super Rugby, there's a gap before the Currie Cup starts again, so it is a bit different, but you know, at least like that, every player gets a fair amount of chances to play.
I suppose it's all part of the experience of coming up to the Northern Hemisphere and trying something different.
Yeah, yes, definitely. I think it's a total different structure, which is nice. I'm enjoying it so far. Go, go, go.
And it's important that we get back to winning ways this weekend, get a good performance in and make sure that we keep the scoreboard moving.
Yeah, definitely. I think we need to stay positive. I mean, it's just, you know, it's one result that didn't go away after winning a fair few games. I said in one of these interviews, just after the preseason games, don't read a lot into, you know, one or two games, you know. So hoping for a good result this weekend.
That's all for now. Don't forget, tickets are on sale at all the usual outlets, so make sure you buy your ticket now and get the Liberty Stadium this Friday night to support the cause.